to show you our determination of equal chemical equivalent of copper and reduction factor of a Helmholtz galvanometer. Order code is 55860. So here this is the battery eliminator. Here from here we will give the power supply to the voltmeter. So this is the voltmeter. Here in the voltmeter we have given copper sulfate solution and the copper plates are merged into this solution. So this is a reversible key and this is the galvanometer. So to perform the experiments, we will make this circuit here. So first, from the copper plate we will connect the positive power supply now we will connect the negative power supply to the reversible key. Reversible key. Now we will connect the galvanometer with the reversible key. So first connect this here. So we will connect one end of this reversible key to the galvanometer here and we will connect the other end here to the galvanometer. Now from this terminal of the reversible key we will connect the voltmeter. Now we will make sure that the cathode should be the middle plate and we will take any of this plate as anode. So this one will go to the middle plate and the positive power supply of the battery will connect at this end. We can also connect this here as these two ends are shorted. Now after this is done, we need to set this coil at zero position. So move the coil so there is a reading of zero. The pointer is at both the pointer is at zero position. Now before we start the experiment, wet this copper plate in a chemical box. After that merges this in copper sulfate solution. Now move this commutative reversible key in one direction. So we can assume this is a direct current. Now turn the power supply on and slowly increase the current and note the deflection in the galvanometer. So this is the deflection of the galvanometer. The reading should read 45 degree. So if there is not any 45 degree, the reading should read 45 degree. To make the solution more conductible, you can add H2SO4 to increase the conductivity of the solution. So in that case the current flowing through the coil will also be increased and the deflection of the angle will also be decreased. So make sure that the deflection is 45 degree. So we can assume that this is the deflection is for direct current. Now note down this current, and after that we will switch off this reversible key. Now we can see when this reversible key is in off position, there will no current flow between the copper plates and the galvanometer reading will be zero. After that, move it towards the opposite direction and note down the deflection. This is the angle for the reverse current. Take out the copper plates from the solution and then merge it into a fresh water and dry it, and after that take the weight of the copper plates in the chemical balance. The difference of the mass will be the mass of copper that is deposited in the solution. Now take a stop clock and observe this diffraction after 5 minutes of interval and note down the readings here in the table. So from this angles, readings of the angles, we will get the mean value of the angle, and from that we can conclude the tan theta. Now from this we can figure out the reduction factor. This is the formula given in the manual to figure out the reduction factor. So for the formula is K equals to M. M is the mass of the copper that is deposited in the copper solution, and Z is the electrochemical equivalent of copper, and tan theta is the deflection angle. From here we can get the reduction factor, and also we can get the Z using this formula. This is the mass of copper deposited in the solution, and this is into 32 into pi into N. N is the turn of the coil, divided by 50 into root 5 RH tan theta into T. T is the time that we have observed with the help of a stop clock.